prior to our knowing about the BRCA1 and BRCA2 genes, everybody noticed that there were certain families that had a propensity to develop both breast cancer and ovarian cancer. When the BRCA1 gene and subsequently the BRCA2 gene were discovered, it gave us an opportunity to test patients and separate out those patients and their families who carry that gene and therefore have an increased risk of breast cancer and ovarian cancer from those patients who don't. Patients that carry the BRCA1 or BRCA2 gene have genes that are supposed to stop the development of cancer but are mutated such that cancer can develop more commonly, and those two cancers are in the breast and the ovary. When one looks at a patient or a family that has this gene in the family, the breast cancer rate can approach 80%, and the lifetime ovarian cancer rate can be up to 25 or 40%. When we see patients, we ask the question, is there a family history here that would indicate that this gene may be present? And those questions revolve around the age of the patient, the age of the other members of the family that had either breast or ovarian cancer, and the number of those relatives that had those cancers.
Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.